Hello, boys and girls, and welcome to Miss Elaine's Book Nook, where every month I'll bring new and exciting stories to share with you. Today's story time is all about vegetables. Crispy, crunchy, healthy, and delicious vegetables. And I brought some veggies on the show with me today. Some of these I'm sure you've seen and tasted, and others maybe not. Here we have a potato, right? We've all seen a potato before, and this tastes delicious a lot of ways. French fries are potatoes, and you can have mashed potatoes, roasted potatoes, hash browns, all different kinds of potatoes. And we all know what this vegetable is, right? Carrots taste delicious raw, crispy and crunchy, maybe in a dip, and they also taste delicious cooked. Carrots grow from the ground too, and they're very good packed with vitamin A and vitamin C, which is really good for your eyesight. This vegetable called? Do you know? This is a delicious red bell pepper. And they come in green, orange, and yellow too. But what about this vegetable, boys and girls? Have you ever seen this leafy green vegetable? This is one of Miss Elaine's favorites, and this is called kale. And kale is really, really good for you too. Again, packed with vitamin A and vitamin C and lots of potassium that really makes you strong. Can you show me your muscles, boys and girls? Can you make a muscle at home? Show them off. Very good. And kale will make you even stronger. Then I know everybody knows what this is. This is a yummy summertime treat, although we can have it all year round. We eat a lot of it in the summer. This is fresh corn. And I have other things in my basket like cucumbers and celery and yummy green beans. Boys and girls, it's important that you try all different kinds of vegetables because you don't know if you're gonna like it until you try it, even if you try just one little bite, right? In our first story, Martha does not like green beans. She won't try one. Not one little bite, not ever, ever, until one day. Let's read how Martha saved her parents from green beans. Every Tuesday evening, Martha's family had green beans for dinner. Every Tuesday night, Martha was left alone at the table, staring at a plate of green beans that she would not eat. "Green beans are good for you," said her mother. "Green beans will make you big and strong," said her father. "They're both wrong," thought Martha. "Green beans are bad, very bad." But even Martha did not know just how bad green beans could be. Not until the day that a gang of mean green beans swaggered into town. These beans had black beady eyes and long curly mustaches. They wore tall cowboy hats and sharp pointy boots. They chased old ladies up and down the street. They threw rotten tomatoes at the teachers. They stormed into restaurants and tossed the cooks into garbage cans. Anyone who had ever said, "Eat your green beans," was in big, big trouble. Martha's parents were reading in the den when the green beans barged into the house. The bad beans jumped on top of the furniture. They tied her parents with long, leafy vines. They whooped and hollered and made rude noises. Martha was in the kitchen staring at a plate of cold beans. When she heard the ruckus, she ran into the den. It was empty. The front door was open and a note was tacked to the wall. And the note said, "We have taken your parents, the beans." Uh-oh. The beans kidnapped Martha's parents. What is she going to do now? No more parents meant no more nagging to clean up her room. No more parents meant no more going to bed when she wasn't sleepy. And no more parents meant no more green beans for dinner. Ever! Hooray! Shouted Martha. She threw her plate of cold green beans right out the window. And then she grabbed a box of cookies and settled on the couch to watch her favorite movies long past her bedtime. Martha was happy, but not really. She missed her parents, and she wanted them back. By morning, she knew what she had to do. What do you think Martha's plan is? How is she going to get her parents back from those bad green beans? She marched out of the house and followed a trail of leaves that led her to a cave. Outside the cave, she saw her mother and father tied to a rock. They were surrounded by hundreds of green beans, laughing, dancing, and singing off key. Look at all those green beans. They have them surrounded. Give me back my parents, shouted Martha. The beans did not even look at her. Untie them right now. The beans only snickered. Let my parents go, or I will. Or you will what? Said the beans. Or I will eat you, shouted Martha. Martha's never eaten a green bean in her entire life. But will she do it now? She's willing to do it if it's going to save her parents. The air grew cold. The singing and dancing stopped. The leader of the beans stepped forward and spat on the ground. You will not eat us, he said with an evil sneer. You have never eaten a green bean in your life. He took a step closer to Martha. Then another, and another, and with every step, the beans seemed to grow larger. He climbed onto a rock and looked Martha in the eyes. You are too much of a coward to eat a green bean. Martha's legs felt like melting butter. She wanted to run in home and hide beneath her bed, but she pinched her nose, opened her mouth, and swallowed that bean in one big gulp. The other beans gasped. Can you make a gasping sound at home? Why did they gasp? I think the other beans are nervous. They're scared now that they've seen what Martha did. If she ate the leader of the green beans, then she might eat all of those green beans. Martha ate those beans too. When she untied her parents, they hugged her and kissed her and told her that she was very brave. Looks like she ate a lot of green beans. From that day on, Martha's family never had green beans for dinner again. Instead, they had broccoli or corn on the cob or a nice green leafy salad. Everyone knows that there's nothing bad about a nice leafy green salad. Or is there? Look carefully at that last page, boys and girls. Look at that lettuce. Oh, I don't know. That might be another brand new story for next time. So Martha never tried green beans until she had to. But I have a feeling that after she tasted them, she probably really liked them. Green beans are delicious. So green beans, boys and girls, and a lot of the other veggies that I brought in my basket here today are in this next book called Up, Down, and Around. We buy our vegetables at Giant Eagle or Shop and Save, but they all come from a farm, right? They grow in the ground, starting with the seed. Some grow up and some grow down. Farmers pick those vegetables, clean them, and then send them off to the grocery store where we usually buy them for lunch or dinner. So let's start this story, Up, Down, and Around by Catherine Ayers. In the dirt, we'll dig a row, drop some seeds, and watch them grow. Dirt piles up, seeds go down, water splashes around and around. Because we know that in order for them to grow, they need lots of water and sunlight. So they're watering the seeds first. Corn grows up, carrots grow down, cucumbers climb around and around, peppers grow up, potatoes grow down, pumpkins vine around and around, broccoli grows up, beets grow down. Green beans wind around and around. Okra grows up. Onions grow down. Tomatoes twine around and around. Fresh and tasty. Get a bunch, pick some, pull some. Let's have lunch. And look at all those delicious vegetables they're having together. It looks like they made a nice, healthy, crunchy, delicious salad. And over here, a big pot of soup. Vegetables are yummy in a soup. And that reminds me, when I think of vegetable soup, I sometimes think of Tom Chapin's song, Alphabet Soup. In this song by Tom Chapin, which we're going to play in just a couple seconds, he puts a lot of different vegetables with a lot of other crazy things into one big giant pot for a pot of alphabet soup. So we're going to grab a pretend letter from the air, grab yourself a letter, throw it in a pot. Pretend pot. Now pretend you're stirring. Stir it up, stew it up, serve it real hot. Read it while you eat it, feed the whole troop. Can't get enough of that alphabet soup. Let's practice it. Let's do the song. It's a fun one by one of my favorite artists, Tom Chapin.
Now gather round, children. It's time for a treat. Dinner time's coming. Who wants to eat?
I do too.
Then I'll make alphabet soup with you.
Ready? Here we go.
Grab some letter.
Throw it in the pot. Stir it up, stew it up, serve it real hot. Read it while you eat it, feed the whole troop. Can't get enough of that alphabet soup.
Alphabet soup. A is for apple, B for bean, corn, dill, eggs, french fries, greens. Look at C.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G.
What?
Grab yourself a letter, throw it in the pot. Stir it up, stew it up, serve it real hot. Read it while you eat it, feed the whole troop. Can't get enough of that alphabet soup.
Alphabet soup. Ham, bone, ice cream, jelly, ketchup, lamb, meat, noodles, onions. What do you got so far?
H-I-J-K-L-M-N-O-P.
What?
H-I-J-K-L-M-N-O-P. Grab yourself a letter, throw it in the pot. Stir it up, stew it up, serve it real hot. Read it while you eat it, feed the whole troop. Can't get enough of that alphabet soup.
Alphabet soup. Quince, radish, salt, turnips, unicorn horns, veal chop, watermelon.
Unicorn horns.
Play my xylophone while it's stewing. Let's put yams in.
Let's put you in.
Baby zucchini when no one's looking. Now we got the whole alphabet cooking. Alphabet soup couldn't be better. Let's say the whole thing.
Ready?
By letter.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z.
Let's go round and sing it again, then pass me an S, B, O, O, N.
Grab yourself a letter, throw it in the pot, stir it up, stew it up, serve it real hot. Read it while you eat it, feed the whole troop. Can't get enough of that alphabet soup.
Can't get enough
alphabet soup. Very good, boys and girls. Great job. Okay, boys and girls, our next story is about carrots. And in this silly book, the carrots come to life. We all know that's not really possible, but this made-up story is called Creepy Carrots. Let's find out what happens in Creepy Carrots. Jasper Rabbit had a passion for carrots. And the carrots that grew in Crackenhopper Field were the best, crisp and free for the taking. He pulled some for a morning snack on the way to school. He he yanked out a few on his way to Little League practice. He ripped them from the ground on his way home at night. Jasper couldn't get enough carrots. Until they started following him. Uh-oh. He first noticed something strange after the big game against East Valley Hares. Jasper was about to help himself to a victory snack when he heard it. The soft, sinister tunk, tunk, tunk of carrots creeping. Tunk, tunk, tunk. Tunk, tunk, tunk. He turned, but nothing was there. Just my imagination, he thought, but he hopped a little faster. He's a little bit worried. I think he's a little bit scared. That night, as he was brushing his teeth, there they were! Jasper whipped around, but nothing. He laughed at himself, picked his toothbrush off the floor, and went to bed, quickly. Could they really be in his house? Carrots in the bathtub, do you think? I think if I was Jasper, I'd be a little creeped out too. The next morning, he approached Crackenhopper Field slowly. He reached for two wild carrots. Nothing happened. He bit into one. Nothing happened. Phew, creepy carrots. It was ridiculous. But when he arrived home that evening, Mom! Mom! Jasper screamed. Creepy carrots in the shed! His mom opened the door slowly. There weren't any carrots, not even the regular kind. There are no such thing as creepy carrots, Mom said, shaking her head. Later that night, as Jasper lay in bed, he heard it. Breathing. Terrible. Carroty. Breathing. And there, on his wall, do you see the shadow? Creepy carrots! He shouted. Dad! Dad! His dad thumped into the bedroom and threw on the light. They searched under the bed. No creepy carrots. They looked through the closet. No creepy carrots. They opened the dresser drawers. No creepy carrots. Just a bad dream, son, his dad said, shaking his head. Now go to sleep. That wasn't going to happen. Look at Jasper's face. Now he's really, really scared. By the end of the week, Jasper was seeing creepy carrots creeping everywhere. Jasper knew his parents were wrong. Creepy carrots were real, and they were coming for him. But they couldn't get him. Not if they couldn't get out. Jasper looks happier in this picture. I think he has a big idea. How is he going to keep those carrots out? I wonder what he's thinking. Jasper had hatched a plan. First thing on Saturday, he grabbed supplies and headed to Crackenhopper Field. As the sun finally set across Crackenhopper Field, Jasper Rabbit smiled. On his way home, there was no tunk, tunk, tunk. There were no carrot-shaped shadows. His plan had worked. No creepy carrots would ever get out of that carrot patch again. Do you see what Jasper did? What did he build? That's right. He built a fence all around the carrots so that they couldn't escape. And as the sun finally set, the carrots of Crackenhopper Field cheered! Their creepy plan had worked. They were sure of it. Jasper Rabbit would never get into that carrot patch ever again. Oh, so the carrots are happy too. Because the carrots didn't want Jasper eating them, did they? The end. Very good. And today, boys and girls, we're going to end story time with a book called Truck Driver Tom. And again, we're going to see a lot of the vegetables that we talked about on the show earlier today, some of the ones that I know you've tasted at home, and we're going to find out how they start and how they get to the store. Truck Driver Tom. Tom loves to drive his big truck. Vroom, vroom. He revs up his engine. He's off to pick up his load. The farmers had a lot of fresh fruits and vegetables ready for him. Looking good. Tom keeps track of the order as they haul it onto his truck. Look at all the things that he's putting. Bushels of apples, which is a fruit. Potatoes. We saw a potato today. Looks like eggplant back there in that bushel. Clank, clank. Farm trucks are working in the fields. Tom blasts his horn to them. He's on his way. Beep, beep. Beep, beep. You can see all the farm animals on the farm too, and I see a tractor. He has miles and miles ahead to drive. Zoom, zoom. He roars down the highway. Which one is Farmer Tom's truck? Can you see it? Good job. Up he goes over the mountain, down into the valley, and whoosh, into a tunnel. Delays ahead, squawks the CB radio. Tom slows down for the road construction. Tom needs to stretch his legs. He stops for snacks and gas. Fill her up. He's making good progress on his trip across the country to the city. But Tom has to take a detour. Bumpity bump. He loses time with all the traffic in the village. Looks pretty busy, doesn't it? A lot of traffic. People head to the city by boat, plane, train, car. Rumble, rumble. Tom crosses the bridge. Beep, beep. Honk, honk. Tom arrives in the big city at last. Buildings are rising and streets are crowded. Tom delivers his load of fresh fruits and vegetables. Check, check. The order is complete. His job is done. Well done. Tom is hungry, and he finally has time to relax. What'll it be? Asks the waitress. He meets many trucker friends at his favorite diner. Tomorrow, he will hit the road with new cargo on a new route. But now it's time to sleep in his cozy nook. At the truck stop, big trucks hum. Good night, Tom. Over and out. So Tom had a big trip. He went all the way to the country to a farm to pick up all those vegetables and fruits, all of that fresh produce, and he drove it all the way back into the city. That's how sometimes we get our produce delivered to local grocery stores right here in Bethel Park. Well, thanks for watching today's show, boys and girls. Don't forget to eat your veggies, try new veggies, and come to the library to check out lots of fun vegetable books. It was fun visiting you in your home today, but I hope you'll come see me in person. Remember that we have lots of weekly story times every day of the week, our toddler, book babies, preschool story time, and our fun giggle and wiggle class on Monday mornings. Thanks again, and we'll see you on next month's Book Nook. Bye-bye.